from Russia without love. Welcome to Unfiltered. I'm SE Cupp. President Biden is back home after a summit with Russian President Vladimir Putin in Geneva. The two heads of state discussed a variety of issues from Syria to election meddling, human rights abuses to protests. According to Putin, the talks were productive. Biden said, "I did what I came to do," although both leaders admit much was left undone. One thing that was accomplished, however, Biden tangled with the press a bunch, and it wasn't pretty. Now, before I get into it, I want to start by reminding you that I'm an honest broker on this subject. I can't actually count how many columns in print and online, how many monologues on Unfiltered, how many times I took on former President Trump's dangerous treatment and villainization of the press. I actually tried to count. I could not. As you'll recall, of course, Trump repeatedly referred to the media as the enemy of the people. He threatened reporters. He called us fake news over and over and over again. He demanded our praise, saying once that the media should say, "Thank you very much, Mr. Trump," or "Trump did a good job." To which I say, "Sir, this is an Arby's, not North Korea." And he often tweeted at us, especially female members of the media for whom he had a particular ire, including me. He tweeted that I was a flunky, one of the dumbest people in politics, one of the least talented people on television, boring and biased, hard to watch, zero talent, a totally biased loser who doesn't have a clue. He also tweeted that he heard I would be fired soon. That was 2015. And I was also very critical of President Obama's treatment of the press. His administration invoked the Espionage Act to prosecute whistleblowers who leaked to journalists. To quote our Jake Tapper, "Obama did so more than all previous administrations combined." His administration also spied on journalists. None of that was good. Look, every administration has at some point been hostile to the press, but literally jailing and spying on them and turning Americans against the media, calling us fake, it's all bad for public trust and democracy. So it was disappointing to hear Biden sort of rhyme with his predecessor at a summit with Putin, of all people. Putin, a guy who jails journalists. Putin, a guy who warned a Black American reporter during this summit that he'd prevent a Black Lives Matter protest from happening in his country. If ever there were a time to model America's firm and resolute respect for the First Amendment and freedom of the press, it was here in front of Putin with the world watching. Instead, Biden kept the media at arm's length and took unnecessary shots at them. In fact, CNN's Jeff Zeleny said of the arrangement, "I have never seen a president so protected by his aides in terms of often not wanting him to answer some questions." Biden also snapped at CNN's Caitlin Collins, who asked a question about Putin's trustworthiness. "Why are you so confident he'll change his behavior?" she asked Biden. He replied, "I'm not confident he'll change his behavior. Where the hell? What do you do all the time? When did I say I was confident?" When she pressed him and clarified her question asking how their talks amounted to a constructive meeting, he replied, "If you don't understand that, you're in the wrong business." White House reporters from other networks and media outlets were quick to defend Collins, and good for them. The New York Times' Maggie Haberman called her question tough, but completely fair. CBS reporter Caitlin Huey Burns said Collins asked a good and smart question, as usual. Amidst the backlash, Biden attempted an apology, saying, "I shouldn't have been such a wise guy with the last answer I gave." But then he griped that, quote, "To be a good reporter, you've got to be negative. You've got to have a negative view of life, okay? It seems to me you never ask a positive question." So there's a lot to unpack there. For starters, of course, it's not our job to ask, quote, positive questions. The press is not a president's PR shop. The job is to ask tough questions. Questions that might make, you know, one of the world's most powerful people uncomfortable from time to time. Biden should know this. He's been doing public service for a while now. Secondly, as I mentioned earlier, it's a real bad look to bash reporters for doing their job on foreign soil at a meeting with Putin. As New York Magazine correspondent Olivia Nuzzi asked, what kind of example does it set for other countries when the president of the United States insults a member of the free press on an international stage for asking a fair question in good faith? A bad one, I would say. Lastly, telling a woman she might be in the wrong job is all kinds of nope. Do not do it. Turn back now. Don't pass go. Collins did exactly what her job was. She is in exactly the right job. And if you can't handle a tough question, perhaps you're in the wrong job. Look, reporters are not above scrutiny. They're not above reproach. We can take attacks from the powerful people we are covering. Believe me, we do it all the time if we're doing our jobs correctly. This isn't about the fragility of the press. Collins, like every other journalist, will be fine. She's still out there doing her job. But it's unfair and dangerous not to call out Biden's attacks on the press just because he's better than the last guy, just because we like him more. And I do. If we're going to restore trust in media, a trust that Trump eroded by lying about our coverage and personally attacking us, Biden has to set a better example. Biden has to be better. What we saw in Geneva was not good. But luckily, unlike his predecessor, Biden seems to be able to learn from his mistakes. Okay, that's it for me. See you next week.